talking from the standpoint of the form. 2. The intense spiritual and mental stimulation which is being applied today to the masses by the planetary hierarchy. The intent is to bring to an end old forms of living, to create new forms through the process of adjustment, and thus bring in a new civilization based on a more subjective culture. I would ask you to ponder on this last sentence. 3. The pouring in of more light from the astral plane, at present unrecognized, and also the tremendous increase of ordinary physical plane illumination. This produces oversensitivity. The work done by the prevailing use of electric light and the general glare in which humanity now lives, will exact its toll from the race until the human mechanism has adjusted itself to light. Remember that this general use of light is less than 100 years old and is in a cult effect with far-reaching results. I mention these three things because they are responsible for much of the predisposition to sensitivity of an abnormal kind. Occult students well know that at the time of the full moon certain high contacts are easier than at other times, but it is right here, my brother, that the difficulty lies. At the time of the full moon, over a period of 5 days, the moon and the planet are the recipients of more reflected light from the sun than at any other time. For this there is a subjective cause. I can only explain it to you by a symbol which may convey this to you or which may act as a blind. Symbolically speaking, the period of intensive meditation of our planetary logos comes around at the full moon period each month. Just as you have your daily meditation city in your high place, as the sickest point of contact. This produces the pouring in of radiance and the entering in of energy both subjective and objective. For all true students, therefore, their work on the mental plane is facilitated, they are enabled then to meditate more successfully and to attain realization with greater ease. They definitely share in the achievement of the Lord of Shambhala. The moon, as you know, is a shell, an ancient form through which the planetary logos at one time sought expression. It is slowly disintegrating physically but not astrally as yet, and is therefore still closely linked with the astral body of the planetary logos and therefore with the astral bodies of all people. Its influence is consequently more potent at the time of the full moon. Copyright 1998 Lucas Trust. 202. The Treatise on the Seven Rays. Volume 4. Esoteric Healing. Upon all who are unbalanced. This lack of equilibrium, which it really is, will eventually be found to exist between the astral body, the etheric body, and the physical mechanism. Who are definitely aspirants and people who are definitely mental, who profit by these full moon cycles, those who are definitely unbalanced, positively astral, and emotional, and frequently swept by uncontrolled desire, are hindered, overstimulated, and psychically upset by these same cycles. The veil of illusion is lit up at that time with a consequent result of hallucination, astral vision, psychic urges, and those misinterpretations of life, of overemphasis upon aspects of life which we call phobias, lunacy, etc. I would like to make a suggestion here, which is not possible for me to prove to you, but which the future will substantiate. Diseases called mental seldom have anything to do with the mind itself. They are 1. Diseases of the brain. 2. Disorders of the solar plexus. 3. Astral domination. 4. Premature besides what we are already trying to do, by which those of us who are on the second rate could more effectively transfuse our love quality into brothers on the first rate, and vice versa. 5. What is the interrelation and the cooperation among the ray lives, and particularly between the first and second ray entities? 6. How can the example of the close cooperation and friendship between the Master M and the Master K?
Facilitate the
providing those conditions of harmony and peace wherein a brother is faced with his true contrary.